Hello everybody, welcome to Cigar Review TV. Today I'm going to smoke a Gurkha Royal Challenge. Now, if you might look, you can see how nice and pretty this little baby is. Really like their artwork usually. And this is no exception. I am going to be doing the review. It's a little bit dark out here, but I'm not going to be using my light. So this might be a little ridiculous, but I wanted to at least use it on the cigar itself. The part that really, really counts. Very nicely done. It's a Connecticut Ecuadorian wrapper. And, see here, I believe it's a Honduran binder and a Nicaraguan Dominican filler. So there's that part, and now I'm going to switch it off and then turn it back on so you can see my face. Aren't you lucky? Okay, I'm back. Oh no, no. I think I barely got this baby lit. We'll see. A little bit more. I'm kind of burned it up a little bit maybe, but it should be okay. Hope everybody's doing well. Wasn't even going to do a review today, but then I decided why not, and so I don't even have, I'm going to be holding my phone. Not really my phone, but my old phone. A bit of a dry taste to the palate, and also at least to the tongue. Very mellow barn type taste right now, to be honest with you. That's not in a bad way, it's just the way it is. I decided to, I was gonna just come out here and smoke a cigar and have a cup of hot black tea. And I can't get my tea thing going. There we go. Hold on real quick. It's my... I can't really go wrong. It's probably in the very low 50s, if not the high 40s right now, at this moment. And which makes for kind of perfect weather for a smoke, for a cigar smoke. Gurkha, you can kind of see it. It's burning okay. Even with my funky in the dark light. Can you see me? Yeah, you can. It's got a decent draw. It's a little tight, but not bad. So I'm giving it a decent draw. I like that flavor. It's supposed to be about a mild to medium cigar, and that's probably how it will be. The Royal Challenge is one of Gurkha's core cigars. At least that's how they term when they're listing their cigars there. I haven't smoked any Gurkha cigars for a while now. It's been a little while. And there's just so many other cigars out there that I had to start giving some others a try. And but I don't believe I've had any scuffles with any Gurkha cigars. I've been pretty happy with every one of those that I've smoked. They have some very high-end ones and some very value cigars, I guess you want to call them, to where they're not expensive, like $5, something like that. So trying to get the flavor that's coming out on this one off to a little bit different than what I've been smoking a lot of Maduros lately for some reason. When I say I've been smoking a lot of Maduros lately, it means the last couple of cigars I've been smoking with Maduros. I don't usually smoke more than probably 2 to 3 cigars a week, and it's usually, lately it's been 1 to 2, hasn't been a lot, been busy with the holidays and with moving and getting settled in for moving and just life in general, you know. So if the way I'm doing it right now doesn't quite work for you, let me know. Let's say, hey, you're in the fucking dark. What are you doing? Just let me know. And I'll switch up accordingly. If it doesn't matter too much, then that's fine too. Slight, very, very, very slight breeze. So that won't affect the cigar at all. It's a nice flavor, just almost like a buttered bread, a buttered potato bread. Doesn't really taste like that, but that's something that's close to the taste, the feel, everything. A few scattered clouds out there. I'd point the lens to the sky there, but you wouldn't see shit. You don't believe me? Okay. See those clouds? See the stars over there? See my face? Yes, you do. Draw is definitely a little bit firmer on this cigar. Not getting a huge plume of smoke, which is okay. It's not bad. Like a little bit better for me. I can be picky on the draw. Come on. But like I just said, I wouldn't like lower my grade on cigar because it's the draw is a little bit firm. So if it was really firm or really light, then you kind of wonder a little bit. But most cigars that Gurkha makes that I've had have smoked very well, has always usually had a very good draw. I think I've had one, and it was actually one of their lower-end cigars, a $5 cigar. It didn't smoke real good. I was a little bit surprised, but, they're handmade, so different things will happen, and it's not going to be a perfect thing every time, so. I hope everybody had a very good Christmas. I was going to try to do a Christmas review or one before it. Didn't happen. So, Merry Christmas late. I hope everybody had a good time and was able to spend time with somebody that they enjoyed the company of. And I didn't do much. I was at home and I got to spend it with my roommates and my little buddy, their son. Love the little guy. So that was nice. He's funny, he looked forward to the little, pretty much, the little toddler, you want to be all excited for Christmas, but they have a clue yet, when they're really 14 months old, I believe, so next Christmas might be a little bit more exciting for him. I thought about coming out, sitting over there in the hot tub, smoking a cigar. And one, I didn't have a towel with me. Two, I'd have to get in there with just my underwear, and that's not going to happen. And there's people over there, so. Three strikes. Out. Didn't work out. I did my first review here, right over there. That's where I did my first one. If you could see, I don't know if you could see that or not. I just pointed it that way, so we'll see. I hope if anybody has troubles during the holidays that, it's something that really depresses you. Holidays, I can see that with anybody. It's just, unless things are going really good in a lot of different phases, then holidays can be a troubling time for a whole lot of people. And so I just hope that if you are one that did have some trouble, that made it through and you're doing good. And, I don't know, but I'm personally glad that the holiday is over with. I've got New Year's coming up, but at least the way America looks on it, for the most part, it's the start of something new and all that shit, so here's to a good upcoming year for all of us, huh? Most apartment places, condos, all those different places, they have a pool and stuff, and then they have the lounge chairs that you can lay in. These ones actually have really nice thick pads on them. Cushion pads. It's just, I'm quite surprised about that. They're very nice. It's dry, thank God. It doesn't rain out here much, but it does every now and then. So it's making this little thing right here nice. Let me get my ash off of here. It's burning decent. As you can see, it's got quite a thick burn line. That's one thing there. I'm gonna get another drink of tea, hold on. So which side's prettier? This side? I'm kidding. Sorry, I was actually trying to look at where the hole in the cup was so that I didn't spill it on myself, and I was pointing the... I'm a little out of sorts. End of the football season is coming tomorrow. As far as the regular season, a little bit of NFL talk right now, just for a couple minutes. My team, the Denver Broncos, have unbelievably they won their division again. It didn't fucking matter last year though. They were out first game last year in the playoffs. So this year they're gonna try to do that replay. They got to win tomorrow, and they'll lock in the home field advantage, and we'll see what happens with them. The teams I'm rooting for in the AFC going into the playoffs, my Broncos, of course, and then... To be honest with you, a team that's kind of like my adopted second team, the New England Patriots. I really enjoy watching them, and that's mainly because my roommate's like my other best friend, and she's my ex-girlfriend. But so knowing her for so long and kind of going through, you know, watching a team through her, I've come to really enjoy watching them too, so I root for them. That's the AFC. There's got to be another one in the AFC I wouldn't mind seeing doing well. Who else is in there? Pittsburgh? No. No, I didn't even mean to see that. I think Cincinnati is in there. And if that's the case, no, I don't want to see any of those other teams go. NFC, always kind of root a little bit for New Orleans. Not for any reason other than I do like Drew Brees quite a bit. Comes a helicopter. And might get loud for a second. Sounds like a loud one. Looking for it over there. It's because the sound was bouncing off the building, and it's looking all over for it. Anyway, who else is in the NFC that's getting in there? Now, see, the team, the home team here, Arizona, they could get in if they win, and if New Orleans loses to the Buccaneers. I would be shocked if New Orleans loses to the Buccaneers. I don't want to see New Orleans out of the playoffs, but if for some reason that scenario happens, then I'll definitely have a little bit of rooting for Arizona Cardinals. Let's see. I'm not delusional. I don't believe that they will actually get in, but you never know. Weirder shit has happened. What else is in there? Got New Orleans. It's unbelievable. Drawing a blank of... Seattle. I really like Seattle's quarterback. I don't here. I've always hated Seattle as a team. They used to be in my division, so that's kind of a learned hatred. but I really like their quarterback. So San Francisco, they're looking tough too. I don't know if they're in. I think they might be in if they win, something like that. And then who else? Oh, that's right. The Cardinals actually play San Francisco, so that will be. Of course, the Cardinals went into Seattle and beat them, which I don't think anybody expected. I know I didn't. I'm trying to think what else. NFC East, probably the Eagles are going to go in. I've never rooted for the Eagles. I don't hate them or anything. I don't care whether they win or not. That's it. If I root for any team in the NFC, it's going to either be New Orleans or probably Seattle compared to the other teams that are in there. So, yeah, we'll see. That's it for the NFL talk. I still dabble in the NFL, but with the way they've taken the Pro Bowl and shoved it up everybody's asshole, it's not something I care to even think about watching. I don't even care who makes the Pro Bowl. It's a joke to me. I'm shocked, to be honest with you, what they've done to that. Not that it was ever a great game. It was never a game that you couldn't wait to see, but it was always kind of you got to see, you know, the star players, the people that were in the Super Bowl and stuff like that, get together one last time and do their shit. And now you can't even see the people that are in the Super Bowl because they play the Pro Bowl before the Super Bowl. So that's my take on that shit. Any other sport right now I really don't care about. UFC, I watch a little bit. Not much, but a little bit. And I think Anderson Silva is supposed to fight tonight. Might have even actually over by now. And I think he's supposed to fight somebody that he's lost to. So, I don't know. We'll see. But you got to remember, Anderson Silva learns a lot of new stuff from Steven Seagal. Now, say what you will about Steven Seagal. He's an odd seed, okay? His movies are completely ridiculous now. They at least used to be okay back in the day. I was actually looking through Netflix. I was thinking of maybe seeing something. And, which is usually what you do when you watch Netflix. But the problem with Netflix is I start to, I don't know what I want to see, so I start looking through all the different movies. And then I get disinterested in watching anything because there's so many to pick from. And I see like 50 that I wouldn't mind seeing that. And by that time it's like, okay, I've been looking through this for a half an hour, let me do something else with my life. Still burning nicely. The flavor has gone from the bread to just a nice mellow, it's very mellow cigar. I drink a lot of coffee, so I do get, like, if I really taste, I get almost like a bit of a scalded coffee with cream. Get a little bit of that. It's pretty close. What else? There are flavors in there. I just said there are flavors in here, but it is a very mellow cigar though, but it's not too harsh. Sometimes a cigar can be kind of harsh for you, maybe sometimes, depending on the whole situation. I gotta take this thing up before I start burning it. Hold on, let me take the part of this. Ah, son of a bitch. It's gonna be one of these where finding the edge of this mother. Yeah. There we go. I did just watch a movie that my roomies... Hi, how you doing? Hey, look at that. See that? They just watched a movie called Elysium. It's a Matt Damon movie. He's in it. It's not about him. And, that was really... I was surprised. I'm personally a fan of Matt Damon. Partly his name is not too bad. At least his last name. And, but this one, I didn't know if I was going to like it, really. Didn't really care to see it, but then the whole premise of it and everything was... I didn't know really what it was about, and I was impressed. It was very good. I think you could draw a lot of parallels from what the United States is kind of like and stuff like that, with their immigration and different stuff like that. It's just a very interesting movie. It's entertaining, and it was a good movie. I would definitely recommend it. So, if you happen to see that in the Red Box or wherever the hell you get your movies from, might want to give it a try. It's definitely, in my opinion, it's definitely worth it. It is Saturday, the 28th, December, 2013. Holy shit! It's almost 2014, my friends. What the hell's going on, huh? A little bit, how fast time goes is just beyond me. So, I don't know. I hope we all end up having a very good year this coming year. You, me, and the person sitting next to you. Trying to think if there's any other news, any big stuff that I want to talk about. Can't really think of any. There's a few of you out there who I know are very busy and that have done a review or two, and that every now and then takes a gander at mine. Let's just say this. I hope to see you throw one or two quick little reviews up as well. But trust me, I know how it is. I almost didn't do this one today, so it's, unless you're getting paid to do them or whatever, it's a hobby, and you gotta live your life. But I do enjoy seeing your reviews, guys. Mark, and, Mr. New Start there, and quite a few, but sorry, I got some coming off of there. go. Anyway, I'm going to, I think I'm going to go. Just going to hang out a little bit, maybe take a little bit of a walk, and then enjoy the rest of my cigar. So the Gurkha Royal Challenge, definitely worth a try. I believe it was about a $7 cigar, if I remember right. I might be wrong there. I'll see if I could put that in the details. But I hope everybody is having a good life right now. And let's look forward to a very good new year, okay? Let's, if you've had it rough, had some shitty things going on this next year, never know. Life changes on a dime really quickly, so let's all expect nothing but the good shit, all right? Have a great night, great day, great year, great week, great month, whatever the hell it is for you. And I look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye-bye.